Bismillah, alhamdulillah, salatu wassalam ala rasulillah, wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd. Qala al-imam Ahmad rahimahullah ta'ala, hadathana Abu Abdurrahman, Abdullah ibn Ahmad ibn Muhammad ibn Hanbal, qala hadathani Abi, Ahmad ibn Muhammad ibn Muhammad ibn Hilal ibn Asad, min kitabihi, qala hadathana Abdullah ibn Numair, qala akhbarana Ismail, ya'ni bin Abi Khalid an Qais, قال قام أبو بكر رضي الله عنه فحمد الله وأثنى عليه ثم قال يا أيها الناس إنكم تقرؤون هذه الآية يا أيها الذين آمنوا عليكم أنفسكم لا يضركم من ضل إذا اهتديتم وإنا سمعنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن الناس إذا رأوا المنكر فلم يغيروه أوشك أن يعممهم الله بعقابه. It states here that Imam Ahmed's son, Abdullah ibn Ahmed, he says, reporting from his father, Imam Ahmed, he said that my father told me that he reported from Abdullah ibn Numair, who related from Ismail ibn Abi Khalid, from Qais, who said, one day Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he stood up. He gave us a sermon. And in that sermon, he praised Allah and he lauded Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he addressed the people. He addressed men and women. He addressed the Sahaba and the Tabi'een. He said to them, Ya ayyuhan nas. He said, O people, you recite this ayah from the Quran, Surah Al-Ma'idah, Allah says, O you who believe, alaykum anfusakum. Worry about yourselves. Stick to yourselves. Just focus on yourselves. La yadurrukum man dalla idha ihtadaytum. As long as you're guided, then it won't be harmed, or you won't be harmed by those who are misguided. As long as you're doing the right thing, no one will hurt you, no one will bother you with Allah. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he then said, and indeed we heard, he says we, meaning the companions, we heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, that whenever the people see evil, they see vice, they see something which is munkar, something which is bad, and they don't change it, they don't speak out against it, they don't attempt to stop it, then Allah azza wa jal will punish them all. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish all of them. He will give them all a general punishment. So this hadith teaches us many, many beneficial lessons. The first and the most important of these lessons is the obligation, the importance of enjoining the good and forbidding the evil. And that is something which is mandatory. And it's something which is virtuous. And it's something which is very dangerous to be forgotten about. To see the evil and don't say anything. Don't do anything. Don't hate it. Just walk by it. And to become desensitized by the evil that surrounds us. That's number one. Number two, this hadith shows us the severe harm and threat of turning a blind eye towards evil and walking around deaf, dumb, and blind and saying, it's not my responsibility, it's none of my business, what am I supposed to do? Number three, this hadith teaches us is that the Quran and Kareem can be used, but it can be misunderstood or it can be misinterpreted. Or people may differ on the proper interpretation of the Qur'an. And it doesn't mean that they don't have the Qur'an with them, but the interpretation of it. Abu Bakr was speaking to the best of the Muslims, the most knowledgeable of the Muslims. If those people had a misunderstanding, according to Abu Bakr, then what about the people in 2018 in New York City? How will we misunderstand and misinterpret the Qur'an? So he said that you're saying that this ayah, as if it's a proof to just walk away or to take a diplomatic approach towards the evil. Alaykum anfusakum. Stick to yourselves. You do your business and that's it. Khalas. He says, but we heard the interpretation of this ayah from the Messenger of Allah. And that is, when you see the evil, try your best to change it. When you see the evil, try your best to speak out against it. When you see the evil, try your best. Rather not try your best, but you must at least hate it. As the Prophet says in another hadith, that if you see the evil, then change it. If you can't change it, then speak out against it. If you can't speak out against it, then at least hate it in your heart. وَذَٰلِكَ أَضْعَفُ الْإِيمَانِ. That's the weakest of faith. If you don't hate it no more, then as if there's no more faith left in your heart. So therefore, this hadith shows us is that a person worrying about himself is a good thing. A person worrying about his neighbor, his family, his wife, his husband, that's a good thing as well. And they're both obligatory. And there's no contradiction between the two. Worry about yourself, handle your business, and at the same time, look after your brother, look after your neighbor, look after your coworker, look after your little son, etc., etc. And last but not least, this hadith, it shows us the virtue of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, and how much fiqh he had, how much tafsir he had, And this is the job of the leader, to make it clear to the people and to address the people. If he sees the subjects doing something that is incorrect, to allow them to learn what's right and enforce Allah's rules upon him to the best of his ability. And there are other fawaid as well. Wallahu ta'ala alam. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Mubarak ala abdihi wa rasulihi nabiyyina Muhammad.